All right, we're here on a beautiful patio, and who knows, maybe he will bust out and perform because he just never stops touring.
He doesn't. As a matter of fact, he just came back into town for a little while, and he's about to go out again after that. We are talking about Mike Reno from Loverboy. Of course, our rocktologists and scientists are all unanimous in saying Loverboy, one of the most influential. How are you, man?
Good, I appreciate that, too.
Oh, no problem. Well, it's huge. Now, take us back to, let's see, about 1980? I guess. Where were you? What were you doing?
And in 1980, I believe I was just rigging a boat, a 39-foot Sea Ray called the Almost Paradise, which I received after cutting that song. And it was on this very site that I had my boathouse, and now it's condos and beautiful restaurants, and they've changed it all around.
Fans are speaking in a past tense, but you guys have managed to stick around, stay around, sell out concerts. What is it about Loverboy that people love?
You know, I think they just love the music. They relate to the lyrics. It's fun stuff. We're not trying to change the world or, you know, reinvent something. We're just playing music that's fun. And everybody seems to know the words and they get up and sing. And over the years, we've never let them down. When we come to town, we really put on a show and we really put our, you know, our hearts into it. And I think they, over the years, they say, well, let's go to Loverboy. It's guaranteed good times.
I know, everybody's been shouting out their favorite songs all night. This is cool. But I'd like to do my favorite song right now. How's that? Yeah.
Now, MTV just celebrated 25 years. You were the darling of MTV when it first launched. You were one of the first bands to have videos, one of the first bands to be played on music television. What has it been like for you, you know, starting that part of what is music?
I remember when they came to us and they said, we want to do videos. And we kind of went, what are videos? And they go, it's like a concert thing, except we're going to take our time and make it nice. So we went to Albany, New York, and we filmed 3 videos in one day. We just filmed a lot of live performances, and then they edited all the funny stuff into it, and, you know, they did all the cuts and clips. But when we handed 3 songs to MTV, it was the first week they were open. So just because of the fact that we were one of the only bands that handed them 3 songs, all 3 songs started getting heavy rotation, and we kind of became like little mini movie stars or TV stars.
Yeah.
And up until then, bands, you know, you could walk down the street, nobody even recognized you, unless they were just total crazy for you. Like, unless you were Alice Cooper or somebody.
But then all of a sudden, they can attach a face to it.
Exactly. And that's what TV did for us. It made it hard to go out a little bit. But, you know, it made us, you know, super famous at a young age. We got so popular, we couldn't stay in the same town that we played it.
So we fly out.
We would P&W and COT, which is play and wave and change on tarmac.
Super famous 80s debauchery rock and roll part of your career like, and how the hell did you live through it?
What I usually tell people, which is the truth, is if you take anything that you can imagine a 25-year-old with his own Learjet would do, times that by 10, and you're getting close to how it really was.
Really?
Yeah. When we had a day off, we'd fly to Nassau and gamble. We'd take the plane and go golfing at Augusta. I mean, we did whatever we wanted. It was awesome.
How about the leather pants? They've been legendary. You auctioned a couple of pairs off for charity. How did the leather pants do?
Well, I finally got rid of them. I think we raised $1,800 US, which went to JDRF, which is our charity of choice, and we believe in it. We've been working real hard at that for the last 7 or 8 years. You know what I kind of get into telling people now is people really don't come to see Loverboy to see what they're wearing.
Right.
They actually come to have a good time and rock out, you know what I mean? And the leather pants, the reason I bought them in the first place was because they were half price. And if I tell that story, it's not very sexy. They were the ones that fit the best, and they were half price.
I can tell by the look in your eyes, you've been hurting. You know I'll never let you down, oh no.
Mike and I saw you perform at the Commodore not too long ago, and you put your heart and soul into every song, every moment. How do you keep up that energy?
Do you know, I ask myself that often, because I do a lot of shows, and people say, what do you do beforehand? And I say, well, I just really pace. I'm a real worrywart. I have a sick feeling for an hour before the show. And somebody said to me, if you lose that sick feeling, then it's time to retire.
Yeah.
But I'll tell you, it gets bad, and it's getting worse the older I get. Well, what I do is I kind of look up, and I just thank the big guy for giving me the opportunity to do this one more time.
How do you take care of your voice?
Well, I like to drink red wine and smoke cigarettes, you know, that's basically, I don't know how.
Wow, you'd think Mike and I would be rock stars at this point.
Remember, kids, you want to be writing this stuff down at home. These are not, you know, people just your age that are coming to the shows anymore. These are people, you know, they're kids and all these things. So obviously, you wrote a song that people like, period. Doesn't matter the time.
Well, you know, working for the weekend's been in about 12 movies.
Yeah.
And a lot of them are young movies.
That's true.
And Turn Me Loose is in Larry the Cable Guy's movie.
Right.
I mean, it's just one of those things. All the songs just seem to be being pushed into movies. And next thing, they're going to be in all the commercials.
Yeah.
And we'll be selling home hardware stuff or whatever. And you know what? I just got to love it because, you know, it doesn't hurt.
Thank you so much.
Always a pleasure to
talk to you. Always a pleasure.
It's always fun talking to you.
We're always kind of surprised you, actually.
So let's just see Perform and Wave, Change on the Tarmac, Cigarettes and Red Wine, and you too can be a rock star for the rest of your life.
Remember, kids, write it down. Write it down.
IQ, good night!
Yeah!